In this video, I'll help you create a linear regression model using TensorFlow 2.0. So let's start by importing the necessary modules. I have a simple file called as data.csv, which I'll load into a data frame df. Let's also move forward and visualize the first 5 rows of the data frame. So this is exactly how my data frame looks like. I have a feature column called as x and I have a target variable called as y. The next thing that I'll do is I'll kind of try to plot a scatter plot between the x values and the y values. So let me run this cell. So this is what we get in form of a scatter plot, where my x values correspond to the x column in the data frame and the y values correspond to the y column in the data frame. It is evident from the figure that when you increase the x values, your y values correspondingly increase. So that is the task in hand, wherein we'll try to implement a linear regression model using TensorFlow 2.0. So let's get started. The first thing that we'll do is we'll kind of create an instance of the model. So that is where the first line of code comes in handy. Once the model is instantiated, the next thing that I do is I'll kind of add a layer. Now think of this as a neural network, but with one hidden unit. So given if I have just one hidden unit and if I have one input coming in, then there are only two parameters that I need to compute. That is the weight connecting to that input layer as well as the bias of that node that is there. So again, just to reiterate what I've just mentioned, I had one column which is x, I had one column which is y. X is my input, y is my output. Now in the normal linear regression convention as well, when you perform linear regression, you kind of try to compute the weight values. Now the weight values along with the intercept term is what you want to compute. That is where this dense layer comes in handy. So the way you read this dense layer is basically, the first parameter is the amount of output that you have or the dimensions of the output that you have. So in our case, we are outputting just one value, which is the y value. So that is where the output is 1 and the input underscore shape is equal to 1. If we had two features like x1 and x2, then the input underscore shape value would have been equal to 2. Now that we've added a layer in the model, the next part is to compute the loss, that is how far is my actual output value from the predicted output value. So in case of regression, the loss function is mean squared error, which is what we are trying to incorporate in this model. And we are also passing in the optimizer. So there are various optimizers that are available. I'm using the Adam optimizer for this task. I'll also create a video on the optimizers as well. So let me run this cell. After running the cell, let's try to understand the summary of the model. So let me run this cell as well. Going by the summary, as you can clearly see, I have an output of one dimension. That is, I had y equal to one column. So that is where your output shape is none comma one. It also specifies the total trainable parameter. So when you think of regression, you have two trainable parameters that you want to find out. That is your weight and the intercept term, which is what is signified here. Now that the model structure is ready, let's actually pass in the values of x and y and run it for 300 epochs in order to compute the most optimum value of weights for this particular combination of data that we have. So let me run this cell. As you can clearly see, the model is training right now. I have also switched on the GPU so that I have like a good speed up in terms of computation. So finally, after 300 epochs, we have converged to a small loss value. And let me plot the loss as well. So as you can clearly see, in the initial epochs, the loss was very large, which has been kind of brought down with time. And we've reached an optimum value of weights as well. Now, if I take the same training data value and pass it through the model, I'll get the output values as well for that corresponding x value. So let me run this cell. Given now we have the predictions, the actual values and the x values with us, let's plot a scatter plot and the best fit line that we were able to compute using TensorFlow 2.0. So let me run this cell. So your blue dots signify the scattered points which are there in our training data set. And the red line shows the actual predicted line that we were able to compute using TensorFlow 2.0. So this was my attempt in explaining how you can use TensorFlow 2.0 to come up with like a best fit line for a given set of features and a target variable. I hope you enjoyed the video. It would be really motivating if you can press the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to be notified for future amazing videos on data science and machine learning. Thank you so much for watching the video.